Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Wherever you're watching this from, welcome to Assam Live. This is Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful summer Sunday. Summer is the season in space where the international tournaments take place. Summer is when players raise their stock or whether their price might drop. After the Euros, conversation has been circling around the most valuable player in the beautiful game of football and soccer right now. And from all indicators, the agents are wheeling and dealing. Summer is where the most business is done. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports. You already know the game is always in motion and locomotion. The game don't wait. The game is always in motion. And the transfer window is open. The market is ready to sell. Agents are wheeling and dealing. And teams have been in business trying to fortify their squads. Agents are trying to fill their coffers. And players are trying to move on to more success. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports on this bright, beautiful, special Sunday. We are talking transfer news. And the biggest player, arguably, in the world of football right now is Nico Williams. The Spanish 21-year-old kid was amazing during the Euros. Conversation has been circling around Barcelona making a move for the young kid. He currently plays with Atletico Bilbao. The combination between him and Lamine Yamal at the Euros was the talk of conversation throughout the tournament. It will be good business if Barcelona is able to make a move for Nico Williams. They are talking it must be 100 million over if you go by the prices that certain teams have paid for certain players. Thank you for tuning into Assam Sports on this beautiful Sunday. The skies are blue and gray. The stars are looking to shine bright in the impending season. Agents are wheeling and dealing. And the most shocking, but also not surprising news in the transfer news, besides the Nico Williams, N'Golo Kanté the Great. N'Golo Kanté the Great, even though the French team didn't perform to expectation, one player you could say, N'Golo Kanté of the French team, who really raised his stock, his performance in the Euros was quite, like I said, it was shocking, but it wasn't surprising. People were of the view that once you make a move to Saudi Arabia, you dip in your form. It is a place where players go to end their careers, but unlike the other players who went to Saudi Arabia in search of treasure, N'Golo Kanté made a move to Saudi Arabia, one for lifestyle, family, but most importantly, N'Golo Kanté went to Saudi Arabia so he would be close to God and his maker. And that tells you everything you need to know about the greatness of N'Golo Kanté. And he's still, when N'Golo Kanté is fit, there's no midfielder in the world that could light a match. Due to the nature of his size, I think his size understates his greatness. But N'Golo Kanté is one of the greatest football soccer players who has ever graced the game in the past 50 years. You can talk of the likes of Franz Beckenbauer in the Beckenbauer style of play. You could talk about Xavi Alonso in the Xavi Alonso style of play. You could talk of Michael Essien, who developed a certain style of play. Makalele, the name goes on, but when you are mentioning these names, you have to mention N'Golo Kanté on that list. When he is fit, rumors circulated that N'Golo Kanté might be making a move back to the Premier League. West Ham is the conversation, but I would even say, why would N'Golo Kanté go to West Ham? No disrespect to West Ham. It would be a very good move for them. If I was West Ham and this move was on the table, 20 million, I would sign my papers as fast as I can. Bush, 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 sealed, delivered. But I think if N'Golo Kanté is making a return back to the Premier League, why is Chelsea not in the conversation? And it also always comes back to my perception of this Chelsea ownership. I've seen them buying certain players during the transfer. I don't even want to comment about the business that Chelsea is doing in the transfer window now. They haven't sold anybody.
and they got Drewsbury Hall.
Now, I mean, no disrespect to Drewsbury Hall. He's a great winger, but we don't need wingers. We have lots of wingers. Chelsea is a team of chicken wings. The wings everywhere. Wings. Why is Drewsbury Hall the acquisition? N'Golo Kante is willing to come back to the Premier League. Thiago Silva has left. Any team, any common football sense will let you know that it is a good decision to have a senior player with experience. I mean, N'Golo Kante might not be the most vocal leader, but sometimes the best way to lead is not by just being vocal, but by leading in your character, your actions. N'Golo Kante in this Chelsea team is going to, I mean, he's already a Chelsea player. He left because he felt he needed something in his life. He wanted to get closer to his God, and maybe this Euros and his performance has prompted him to maybe want to make a last dance on the high level playing field. Why is Chelsea not all over this? Thank you for tuning into SM Sports. We are talking transfer window, transfer news. I mean, of course, Manchester United have also been busy. They've acquired players like a Euro, a French left center back. They bought it from Lille. They also bought Xerxes, another Dutch player, after a disappointing recruitment by Erik ten Hag for the Brazilian winger Antony. Erik ten Hag is bringing another. I mean, what is all with these Premier League teams and wingers? If you know the game is won from the middle. No matter how good your wingers are, if the distribution doesn't get to them accurately, their swiftness is tantamount to nothing. So I don't know why Chelsea hasn't made any move yet. We need a striker. It's only 4 weeks away from the Premier League commencing. Chelsea needs to get an out-and-out striker. Nicholas Jackson, as good as he is, as fast as he is not the answer. Thank you for tuning in to SM Sports. And speaking of Chelsea, and the other Premier League teams are coming to the United States for the Summer League games. That will be quite exciting, pre-season, but also the Summer Series tournament. I will give you the news as I receive it. Transfer window is happening. Things are bubbling. Business is being done. So far, Manchester United is the team. They've done the most business. Barcelona, will they be able to clinch and steal Nico Williams from Atletico Bilbao? The Bilbao manager put out a press statement during the Euros that indicated they have no interest in selling. But when the cash is ready, when the amount is ridiculous, difficult minds might change. Thank you for tuning in to SM Sports. Like you already know, the forecast 1.0. New SM Music Collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. Happy Sunday. This is SM Sports. Go back out there.